Hello everyone, good morning students. Dear students, in previous class we take and discuss a very important chapter of our syllabus, which is what? Triangles. And in previous class we discuss about the important property of triangle, and we take and prove some important properties, theorem related to triangle. And we discuss about what the condition for congruency of figures, and we also take and solve some important question of your NCERT exercise based on SAS congruence criterion. SAS means what? Dear students, side angle side congruence criterion. Okay, and you know that if two triangles, suppose that ABC, if triangle ABC is congruence to triangle PQR. In that condition, by CPCT means what? The congruent part of corresponding triangles. Corresponding part of congruent triangles are equal to each other, means angle A is equal to angle P, angle B is equal to angle Q, angle C is equal to angle R, as well as side AB is equal to side PQ, side BC is equal to side QR, and side AC is equal to side PR. This is the concept of CPCT. Corresponding part of congruent triangles are always equal to each other if two triangles are congruent to each other. Now, dear students, we take and solve some important question of your NCERT exercise based on that property. And we also discuss a very important theorem related to that topic, the side opposite to the angle supposed to equal sides are always equal. So that theorem we also proved that in previous class. Now, previous class we take and solve some important question of your syllabus. And your question is, prove that measure of each angle of an equilateral triangle is 60 degrees. Now let's see its assumption. Okay, this is your question here. What is your question? Your question is, prove that measure of each of an angle of an equilateral triangle is what? 60 degree. Now, what I do for that? So, first of all, we form an equilateral triangle. Okay? So, let's see its solution. So, first of all, we form an angle AB, we draw an angle equilateral triangle ABC. So let us consider an equilateral triangle ABC. Okay, in which, you know that in equilateral triangle all of its sides are equal to each other. Okay, let's consider ABC, an equilateral triangle ABC in which side AB is equal to side BC side AB is equal to BC is equal to CA. You know that in equilateral triangle all of its sides are equal to each other. Okay, now what I do, dear students, for that question? Now, we apply the previous property. We know that the angle opposite to equal sides are equal. Let AB is equal to AC. That is, we can write angle B is equal to angle C. That is, angle B is equal to angle C. And because of angle opposite to, this is the angles opposite to equal side. Angle angles supposed to equal sides are always equal. You know that very well. Okay. Now, similarly, if we take BC is equal to CA, then we have what? If this angle is equal to, then angle A is equal to angle B. That is, angle A is equal to angle B. Okay? Because of, you know that angles opposite to equal side. Angles opposite to equal side. So, in this way, we have that result. Okay? Now, by using the angle sum property of the triangle. Now, by angle sum property of triangle ABC. Now, angle sum property of triangle ABC. You know that what is your property? The sum of all entire angle of a triangle is 180. That is, angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equal to 180 degree. Now we put, so in this way here angle B is equal to angle C and angle A is equal to angle B, then using that concept we can write angle A is equal to angle B is equal to angle C. Now we put angle B as angle A and angle C is also equal to angle A. So from there we can write as what? Angle A is equal to, we put angle A, B is equal to angle A, as well as angle C is equal to angle A also. Okay, because of all our angles are equal to each other using that relation. So we get what? Angle A plus angle A plus angle A is equal to what? Take here equation number. So from this, this 3 times angle A is equal to what? 80. So 3 6 is 18, 0. So we have angle A is equal to 60 degree. So we have to show that angle A is equal to 60 degree. Now from equation 1 we get what? Angle A is equal to angle B is equal to angle C is equal to 180. Hence 60 degree. Thus, dear students, in this way we have to show that, we can say that the measure of each of an angle or angle of an equilateral triangle is 60 degree. So first of all, we draw an equilateral triangle, and after that we apply the property in an equilateral triangle we know that all of its sides are equal to each other. So from there we have angle AB side, AB side, BC side, C, all are equal to each other. Now after that we apply the property angles opposite to equal sides are always equal. So here, so we apply that concept. So from there we have a relation what? Angle A is equal to angle B is equal to angle C, and also we know that the sum of all angles of a triangle is what? 180 degree. So 180 degree. Now from there we apply using equation 1. So after simplify them we get angle A is equal to 60 degree. So from using 1, each of an equilateral triangle, angle A is equal to angle B is equal to angle C is equal to 60 degree. Okay, so this is the concept of that. So in this way you can solve that type of question. Now we take and solve some other important question of your NCERT exercise based on that property as well as side angle side congruence criteria. Let's see. And question in the given figure, your question is it is given that AE is equal to AD and BD is equal to CE.
and VD is equal to CE. Prove that triangle AEB congruence to triangle ADC. AEB congruence to triangle ADC. This is the question here. Now first of all, if we draw the figure here, the figure is here. ABC here. This is A, this is B, this is C, CD, DE. This is your B, this is your CD, which intersects at point 4. Now let's see its solution. Dear friend, we have to show that triangle AEB is equal to congruence to triangle ADC. Okay? This is the question here. This is your figure, and you have to show that the triangle AEB congruence to triangle ADC. Now let's see it proof. So first of all, now we have. First of all, we write we have what we have. Let's see. We have is A is equal to AD. A is equal to what? AD, na? A is equal to AD, and CE, dear friends, CE is equal to VD. So and CE is equal to what? VD. CE is equal to VD. Here take equation number 1 and this is equation number 2. Now, here A is equal to AD and CE is equal to BD. Now we have to show, first of all we adding equation 1 and 2 because of in triangle A, we have to show the angle AEB, na? A is congruence to triangle ADC. So for that, first of all, let's see. AEB, okay. So now adding equation 1 and 2. Now equation 1 plus equation 2. So we get what? A plus C is equal to what? Okay. So now we have what? A plus C. A plus C is what? This is AC. And what? AD plus DB is what? Yes, sir. AD plus DB is equal to what? AB. This is what? AB. Okay. So take question number 3. Thus, now in triangles AEB and triangle ADC, what we have? Let's see. So A is equal to AD. First of all, it is given that A is equal to AD because of A is equal to AD is given that now A AB. Okay, A is equal to AD. A is equal to AD. This is given. This is what? Given. Now, let's see here. Dear friends, one important thing is that here, angle EAB, let's see. Angle EAB and EAB, angle EAB is equal to DAC, that angle is common. Angle DAC, or you simply write angle A is equal to angle A, which is common in both the triangle, And last one is what? AC is equal to AB, or AB is equal to AC. This is from 3, from equation 3. Thus, by SAS congruence criterion, thus by side angle side, by SAS rule, we have what? Triangle AEB is congruence to triangle ADC. Hence proof.
Okay, thus in this way you can prove that type of question. Now we take and solve some other question of your syllabus. Let's see. Now we take and solve some important questions related to the SAS congruence criterion, which is what? Let's see. Prove that this is very important question of NCERT exercise, NCERT book. Prove that the angles opposite to equal sides of prove that the angles opposite to equal sides of a triangle are equal. Okay, so we have to show that the angles opposite to equal sides of a triangle are equal. So first of all, we form a triangle. Let's see its proof. So first of all, we draw a triangle ABC. Okay, now present here, first of all we write given. What is given? So in proving any result, any theorem, first of all we write the given. So given is what? He proved that the angles opposite to equal side of a triangle are equal. So here E, in which ABC is a triangle, here triangle ABC in which AB is equal to AC, in which side AB is equal to side AC. Okay, and we have to do and to prove what I prove So what? Prove that the angles opposite to equal sides are equal. The angle opposite to equal side is what? Angle B and angle C, na? So we have to show that angle B is equal to angle C. To prove is what? Angle B is equal to angle C. We have to show that angle B is equal to angle C. Okay? Now, we have to do some construction. Let's see. Construction is what? We draw the bisector of angle A, which is meet the BC at point D. This is the bisector of angle A. Okay, we draw the bisector AD. We draw the bisector AD of angle A, which meets BC at in D. Okay, so we have to do some construction for that question. What is the construction here? Here, dear friend, we draw the bisector AD of angle A, which meets BC in D. This is the bisector, means what? Angle BAD is same as angle CAP. Okay, that angle is equal to this angle. Okay, now in proving that result, means angle AB is equal to angle C, first of all we have to show that the triangle, here two triangles are formed, ABD and ACB. So first of all we take now
in triangles A B D and A C D. Now in triangles A B D and A C D. A C D. We have Now let's see. Now in triangles ABD and ACD we have what we have. Let's see. Dear student, here AB is equal to AC. AB is equal to AC, which is what given. AB is equal to AC, which is what given. Okay. Now and we draw. By construction, we draw AD as a bisector of angle A. Means angle BAD, angle BAD is same as angle CAD. Angle CAD. This is by construction. This is what? By construction. And AD is equal to AD, which is common, side. AD is equal to AD, which is common side. Okay, common side. Thus, by which criterion? Congruence criterion. Thus, by angle side angle, because of two corresponding sides and the angle between included between them are equal to each other. Thus by SAS congruence rule or criterion, triangle ABD is congruence to triangle ACD. ACD. Thus by CPCT, CPCT means corresponding part of congruent triangle, and by CPCT means what? Their corresponding part of congruent triangles are equal to each other. That is, corresponding angles is what? Angle B is equal to angle C. Thus by CPCT, angle B is equal to angle C. Angle B is equal to angle C. Hence proved. Prove that result. Okay. So in this way, dear students, we have to show that ki the angle opposite to equal sides, the angle opposite to equal sides of a triangle are always equal to each other. So using that result, we can solve so many questions of your NCERT exercise based on these results. So this is one of the most important result of your topic. So please remember that result always in your mind. Okay, now which is very important. So first of all, we draw a triangle, and in that triangle we have two equal sides. AB, AC is given in your question, and we draw AD as a bisector of angle A, which meets BC in A in D. Now we have to show that triangle ABD and triangle ACD are congruent to each other by the help of SAS congruence criterion, and then by CPCT means corresponding part of congruent angles are equal to each other. So here corresponding angles B is equal to C. Okay, so hence prove. So in this way, the angle opposite to equal sides are equal. Now we take and solve some other important question of your NCERT exercise. Let's see. Now the question is, we take an NCERT question. In the given figure, in the given figure,
who is the midpoint of AB?
Who is the midpoint of AB?
Who is the midpoint of AB and CD?
Prove that. And CD, prove that first point triangle AOC is congruent to triangle BOD.
Second one is what? AC is equal to BD
and
third one is what? AC parallel to BD and the figure is, this is AC this is BD
this is point O
this is point what O okay this is the given figure and the given figure given that O is the midpoint of AB and CD. Okay, this is very important question of NCERT. Now let's see its solution. So first of all, now in triangle AOC and triangle BOD, in triangle AOC and triangle BOD, we have. What we have, let's see. Dear friends, AO is equal to OB. AO is equal to OB because of O is the midpoint of AB as well as O is the midpoint of CD. Na, so that side is equal to that side. So we have AO is equal to OB, which is given. Okay, because of O is the since O is the midpoint of AB. And part angle AOC is equal to angle BOD. These are the vertically opposite angles. And you know that the vertically opposite angles are equal to each other. And AOC is equal to BOD and CO is equal to OD. And CO is equal to OD because of O is the midpoint of CD also because of since O is the midpoint of CD O is the midpoint of CD okay now O is the midpoint of CD. So CO is equal to OD. Now, thus by SS side angle side, thus by SAS congruence criteria, ki triangle AOC is congruence to triangle BOD. Hence, first part is proved. AOC is by BOD congruent to their first part is proved. This is proved the first part. And by CPCT, now by CPCT. Now by CPCT means corresponding parts of congruent triangles are also equal. So corresponding parts is what? Now let's see. AC is equal to BT. This is AC is equal to BT. By CPCT means corresponding parts of congruent triangles. Okay, dear friends. Now let's see here third one is what we have to show that AC parallel to BD it is very clear from the figure ki here two lines AB intersect CD at point O and AC parallel to BD yes because of these are vertically opposite angle then they form the alternate interior angle so by CPCT we have what angle OAC let's see angle OAC is equal to angle OBD
OBD. Let's see, angle OAB is equal to angle OBD, which are the supposed AB is a transversal and that angle are equal to each other, alternate interior angle are equal. Thus, in this way, AC parallel to what? BD. In this way, in today's class, we discuss the very important congruence criterion, which is SAS, and based on that topic, we take and solve some important questions of your NCERT. Now, in next class, we take and solve some other important question of your NCERT exercise. Okay, dear students, now thanks to all.